very much. Where are we coming from today?
Police are patrolling the busy state line between Victoria and New South Wales, now closed for the first time in a century. And Melbourne is headed into another lockdown. At this public housing complex, the epicenter of 70 new cases, there were scuffles for food. 4,000 people, including Thanissaraag, can't leave their apartments.
We called the hotline. We said, hey, we need sanitary pads. We need milk. We need groceries.
Victoria's premier said people let their guard down.
I think a sense of complacency has crept into us as we let our frustrations get the better of us. I think that each of us know someone who has not been following the rules as well as they should have.
Much of the finger-pointing is focused on quarantine hotels where the virus likely escaped from. This family who returned from India says the room they moved into obviously wasn't cleaned properly.
We found other people's hairs in the bed sheets, nails on the carpet, some food particles and food wrappers under the bed.
The 191 new cases reported Tuesday in Victoria may not be a lot by international standards, but what's worrying is the trend is headed back up, says this Canadian expert.
As people begin to think they've got it beat, as things are loosening up, the virus, which has been dampened but not eradicated, will come back up again.
Closing the state border is creating logistical nightmares. People in communities that straddle the line need permits to cross, to shop or work.
This is something entirely different. This is going to affect the travel of my staff because I have staff and clients on living and working on both sides of the border.
As for Melbourne, long lineups returned outside grocery stores. It's back to essential trips only outside the home. Australia's halting economic recovery from COVID is on pause. Chris Brown, CBC News, Vancouver.